Very often the issue is understanding what questions to ask. And if you can properly frame the question, then the answer is the easy part.
I want to give you my favorite 10 questions that I think are the most important questions that you can ask to get momentum in your life. Let's go.
I find that levels of success in almost any industry or area correlate to a person asking great questions.
Rise and shine, it's Entspresso time.
I wake up every morning.
Espresso, keep me going.
I wake up every morning.
Hey, it's Evan Carmichael, and this channel was created to help you overcome the number one challenge that is holding you back, a lack of belief in yourself. You watch these videos because you know there's something more inside you too. You have Michael Jordan level talent at something. So let's start your day off right together, grab your coffee, and sip on today's message from Elon Musk. Also, if you want to have more confidence, check out my 254 series. They're free. The link to join are in the description below.
There are just times when something is important enough, you believe in it enough, that you do it in spite of the fear.
When you were in college and developing these skills, you wanted to do some things that were of benefit to humanity. Why did you think that?
Well,
because not everyone does.
Yeah, no. I guess it was, I had sort of a existential crisis of like, what does it all mean? And what's the meaning, you know, what's the meaning of life? And
was this 3 a.m. over a beer, or this was more serious?
Probably goes back to high school, I guess. I don't want to give a laboriously long answer, but I had sort of a dark childhood. It wasn't good. Probably partially brought on by reading some of the philosophers, like, don't ever read Schopenhauer, Nietzsche if you're 14. It's not good.
Yeah, or Ayn Rand either, too.
Yeah. yeah, so I was just trying to figure out what, you know, what does it all mean? And when I read The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, which I think is a great work of philosophy, that sort of highlighted the point that very often the issue is understanding what questions to ask. And if you can properly frame the question, then the answer is the easy part. So I thought things that expand the scope and scale of the human consciousness and allow us to better ask questions and, you know, and achieve greater enlightenment, those are good things. And so that's sort of what can we do that's going to most likely lead to that outcome?
I'm going to take a slightly different approach on this video because the topic of this video is how to ask the right questions. I want to give you my favorite 10 questions that I think are the most important questions that you can ask to get momentum in your life. Let's go. Question number one is, what is your who? What is your who? What is your one word most important core value? I talk about it in my book, Built to Serve. You can check it out at evancarmichael.com/book. But what is your who? What is the most important core value that you have that is above all others? Because that will give you a lot of clarity over the decisions that you need to make in your life. Question number two is, what is your why? Your why is your purpose. Your purpose comes from your pain. The thing that you struggle the most with as a human is the thing that you want to help other people with for life, because there are so many people who currently are who you used to be, and they need help and they need a beacon of hope. That could be you. What is your why? What is the most painful moment in your life? And understand that there are so many people who currently are suffering with that and you want to help them. Number three is, what's your how? Your why is your purpose. Your purpose comes from your pain. And then your how is, how did you get out of the hole? However you got out of the hole is something that you can then teach other people to do for themselves so that you can serve them and they can get out of the hole just like you did. Number four is, if you knew you were good enough, what would you do? This is a great question that Dr. Tess Crawley gave me in one of our sessions. And she said, if you knew you were good enough, not if you knew that you couldn't fail, but if you knew that you were good enough, what would you do? And I encourage you for all of these to spend a couple minutes. I'm gonna kind of blaze through them in this video, but these are the kind of questions that are worth going to a coffee shop, blocking off, you know, a couple hours of your time and just sitting by yourself and really spending the time in reflection. Because if you get these right, and there's no like right or wrong, but if you get these and you start to understand yourself, it'll make your future path a lot more clear. If you feel like you're doing a lot of work, but you're not getting the results that you want, this is worth it. Take the weekend, spend 3 hours, go to a Starbucks, get some coffee or tea or whatever you love, and answer these 10 questions, because if you answer them honestly, the results will be life-changing for you. So number four, if you knew that you were good enough, what would you do? Number five is, how can you get started right now? Already in the first four questions, we've dug into a little bit of self-awareness. You're knowing yourself better. You're getting some ideas bubbling up. Hopefully you are if you're doing it. If you're not just listening to the video, but actually taking action on it. Number five is how can you get started right now? It's not enough to just know. You have to do. So you've come up with these ideas. What are you going to do? Like today, right now. Immediately. What are you going to do? Teach yourself that as soon as you come up with an idea, you do something. You take action. How will you start right now? Number six is what are your biggest limiting beliefs? What are your biggest limiting beliefs? These are the things that get in the way from you actually accomplishing what you want to accomplish. These are the excuses that we hold on to, myself included, we hold on to that we're really afraid of, but we find a logical reason why we can't do it. For example, my biggest one is I'm afraid of disappointing people. I believe that I'm going to disappoint people, that when I make a video, I'm going to disappoint people. When I go on stage, I'm going to disappoint people. And so here I am, this introvert who's afraid of disappointing people, who hates networking events because I don't like small talking and I don't, you know, have a big need for friendship, all of these things. And so when opportunity comes to me to speak on stage, it's easy for me to come and say, I can't do it. I don't have time. I got other projects. I have to make videos, all these reasons. But really, the limiting belief is I might disappoint people if I show up. And so because I don't want to disappoint people, I'm going to protect myself and not do it. And so I know that enough about myself that then I force myself to go off and do it. And I always end up feeling so much better for doing it as opposed to letting the limiting belief continue on. And so what are your biggest limiting beliefs? What are the stories that keep coming up in your head over and over and over again that when there's an opportunity that excites you, you find a reason not to do it? Really, you're just afraid. But you're not going to admit that you're scared. You're going to find some BS reason to cover it up. What is that BS reason? What are your limiting beliefs so that you can start to catch them in daily life? Number seven is what triggers them. So you have your set of limiting beliefs. Understand what triggers them, because when you know what triggers them, it allows you to be a little bit more prepared. So for me, speaking on stage triggers the limiting belief. When somebody invites me to speak at their event, instantly I'll get to like, oh, you know, panic mode a little bit. And then it's easy to default back into, well, I don't have time to go off and do it, right? I don't have time to do it. I'm too busy. I have too many opportunities in front of me, which are all true, but really it's just because I'm afraid. And so knowing that people giving me speaking gigs, which I want to do, which serves my mission, which is part of my biggest goals, you know, for this year is to do more speaking gigs, knowing that that triggers the limiting belief for me allows me to be more conscious so I can catch it. Because the problem with limiting beliefs is they're subconscious. You don't catch them. You just are doing it normally out of day-to-day life. And so if you know what triggers it in advance, you can write down, this is what triggers my limiting beliefs, you're much more likely to catch it and make better decisions to help you grow. Question number eight is, how will you change your environment today? You are a product of your environment. If you wanna raise your standards, it starts by raising your environment. And so looking at me here, my environment is what's here. You know, the book inspires me, these people behind me inspire me, even the clothes that I wear, this inspires me. I feel like a superhero wearing this. The Doritos bag inspires me. You can't see down below, but I have my neck braces from when I went on tour and I broke my neck last year. All of this inspires me. My desktop, my phone background, all of it inspires me. Set up your environment once and it can inspire you for life. I walk into this office every day and I've got Steve Jobs staring me down and E.P. Giannini and my parents and everybody's looking at me, demanding that I get better, demanding that I pull up and get better, right? They're here staring me down. It's my environment. When I look at my phone, it says on my background, remember your intention, because I set an intention every day and I need to be reminded of what my intention is. So every time I load my phone, I see that reminder of what my intention is and it serves as a trigger to go off and do something bigger. So set up your environment, right? Especially if you know your who. Back to question number one, mine is believe. This is Believe. This is a Believe office for me. This is a Believe environment for me. Create the environment for the one word, most important core value that you want to live by. Set that up, take that list, and then go do something today to build some momentum towards it. Question number nine is, what is no longer acceptable in your life? This is a really powerful question. It's one of my favorites. Chances are you've been putting up with something for too long. You just allowed something into your life, allowed a person, allowed a mindset, allowed a way of thinking, allowed a habit that you don't even know how it got into your life, but it's there. And you've just kind of put up with it. It hasn't been so bad that you've gotten rid of it, because when it's really bad, you do something about it. But when it's just okay, this is why good is the enemy of great. When it's good, you don't do anything about it. So you never go for great, because it's good, you're good, you know, you don't have to do anything. When it's terrible, you fix it, right? if you have a leaky faucet and there's water all over your house, you're gonna go and fix it. But if it's just a little bit coming out every now and then, that's good, it's okay, it's not worth doing it, right? That mindset keeps you from accomplishing major things. And so you have to now raise your standards in various areas of your life. And you can ask yourself, whether it's relationships, whether it's your health, whether it's your business, whether it's your mindset, whether it's your habits, like what is no longer acceptable? What will you no longer tolerate? What has to change? This is not acceptable anymore. I don't want to think this way anymore. What is that for you? Feel that, make it powerful and write it down. And question number 10 is, whose success will you model? Modeling success has been a big ticket for me, a big shortcut for me to be able to learn from people like Elon Musk, learn from Steve Jobs and my parents and, you know, Kanye, all the people that I've learned from, all the people on this channel that I profiled and all of the channels that I have. Whatever you want to do, somebody has done it. Maybe not exactly like you want to do it, but somebody has done it. And success leaves clues. So the more that you are around these people, the more that you're around Elon Musk, you know, you can't hire Elon Musk to be your business coach. Last time I checked, but you can learn from him. You can watch his videos. You can read his books. You can see the interviews he's done. You can listen to the podcast that he's been on. You can learn from him. You can be around him. And if you wanted to think like him, then the more that you consume him, the more you will start to think like him. Chances are the people in your life right now, they don't think like Elon Musk, right? If you want to think more like Elon Musk, hanging around those people is not going to help you think more like Elon. Elon doesn't have a coaching program to sign up for, right? He's not going to call you every morning and wake you up out of bed. But watching his videos can do that, right? I've done tons. You can go back on my various channels and just type in Elon Musk, Evan Carmichael, and see all the different compilations that we've done. There's a lot of content there for you to learn. Whose success will you model? You have ambitions, you have dreams, you have goals, you want to serve, you want to make an impact on the world. There's people who have done it. They're not in your life. And if they are, they're not in your life enough. Bring them more into your life and you'll see your success start to take off. So those are the 10 most important right questions that I think you should ask yourself. I'd love to know your take on it. I've got a special bonus clip that I think you're gonna enjoy, so stick around to the end. But before that, question of the day, I wanna know, actually two things, two questions. One, from the list of 10 questions that I gave, what is the most powerful question for you? Which one hit home the most as I was talking? And two, what question did I miss? What question would you add as the bonus 11th question, the 11 most important questions? You're gonna pick number 11. Let me know down in the comments below. And if you're still here watching, I wanna celebrate you. I love you. Give me a hashtag believe in the comments as well.
I find that levels of success in almost any industry or area correlate to a person asking great questions. In some cases, they seem absurd. In fact, the hallmark, in a way, of great questions is that they sound completely ridiculous. So someone might ask, like Peter Thiel, why can't you achieve your 10-year goals in the next 6 months? As a thought exercise, that's a good question to answer for yourself. And these types of questions come up surprisingly often with very, very impressive folks, whether it's in business, military, entertainment, or otherwise. And the way you can get better at questions is by studying interviews in part. So I studied Larry King, I studied Charlie Rose, I studied Terry Gross, I studied go down the list. I studied Tony Robbins, who does in-person one-on-one interventions at his events in front of 10,000, 5,000 people. And he's just genius with how he uses questions to like pattern interrupt and grab someone's attention and divert them in a more productive direction. Now, why is that relevant? It's relevant because thinking is the process of asking questions. You're asking yourself questions and then you're answering them in your own head. So if you get better at asking other people questions, you get better at asking yourself questions, which means you're improving your thought performance and level of thinking.
If you want to know what kind of thinking Elon Musk applies to have success in business, check out the video right there next to me. I think you'll enjoy it. Continue to believe, and I'll see you there.
I mean, the way I tend to view problems is from a physics standpoint.